नमः ओम विष्णु पादाया कृष्ण प्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांता स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे। हरे कृष्ण एवरीवन। सो वेलकम टू येट अनदर सेशन ऑफ ग्रो थ्रू गीता। So we are discussing shloka number 39 from chapter 3, which is titled Karma Yoga of Srimad Bhagavad Gita. In fact, we've already started discussing this shloka since last episode. We have discussed the first two lines in the previous episode, and today what I would like to do is discuss the next two lines and bring it to a nice wrap. Avritam jnanametena jnanino nitya vairina कामरूपेण कौन्तेया दुष्पूरेणानलेन च। सो इन द फर्स्ट टू लाइन्स कृष्ण इज वेरी नाइसली डिस्क्राइबिंग दैट इवन द ज्ञानीज वाइज पीपल दे हैव अंडरस्टूड दे हैव अक्वायर्ड द नॉलेज दैट दिस कामरूप दिस लस्ट इज अवर नित्य वैरी इट इज अवर इटर्नल एनिमी वी अंडरस्टूड वाई इट इज अवर इटर्नल एनिमी and how dangerous it is for us to presume that I have overcome this enemy called lust. And in that context, we also talked about the story, the pastime between Srila Vyasadeva and his prominent disciple Jaimini Muni. And now Krishna here in the very last line is disclosing something that is highly instructive, which is dushpurenanalena cha. Krishna is comparing desire, material desire specifically, this lust, to burning fire. So imagine there is a bonfire. Already it is burning, and then if you happen to put a whole bunch of fresh firewood into it, or if you pour some ghee or some kind of fuel into it, what is going to happen to that fire that's already burning? It's going to burn even brighter and bigger and better. So if our intention is to subdue the fire, to put off the fire, then it makes no sense to be pouring fuel into the fire. So likewise, Krishna is telling this enemy called lust is a burning fire. It's always burning within our hearts. And what are we doing? We are pouring fuel into it over and over again. How? By trying to fulfill the desire. All our endeavors in the direction of fulfilling our lust, in the direction of fulfilling all our material desires, no matter how small it is or no matter how big it is all like pouring fuel into the fire. And foolishly, we are thinking that, oh, this is just one desire. I'll just fulfill this and that will be it. I'll be satisfied. No, that's not how it works. Krishna is saying, in fact, it's exact opposite. You're trying to fulfill the desire, thinking that you'll be satisfied. But actually, Krishna is telling, no, sir. If you try to fulfill this desire is going to give birth to 100 other desires. So that's how this fire called lust is going to burn even bigger and better. And then you try to fulfill all those 100 desires, and in that, you know, that gives rise to yet so many more desires. And then here is this big network of desires in which we are trapped. And ultimately, remember, in the previous shloka, Krishna has already clearly said, karma leads to krodha when not fulfilled. And most of the desires will not be fulfilled no matter how much hard work you put in. So let's not set ourselves up for failure by constantly striving to fulfill the desires, because let's face it, we are living in today's world which is actually fueling this fire through advertisements. The whole marketing industry's whole job is to put fuel into this fire called lust. Oh, just imagine if you were to drive that car, you know. And if you were having this flat high-definition television, if you were just having this latest iPhone, if you just lived in this part of the town, in this big bungalow, if only you had that farmhouse, if only you took a vacation to this exotic foreign place, on and on and on. Material world is all about fueling our desires. And we are blindly falling trapped to this and then running one after another, working harder and harder. And ultimately, I'm trying to realize, it's like, why am I not satisfied? This is exactly the reason. So that is why Srila Prabhupada has given this beautiful instruction, simple living, high thinking. Keep your living very simple, but keep your thinking thoughts very high. But in today's world, for most of us, it's exact opposite. High living is our aspiration and no thinking at all. Sheep mentality. Everybody else has it. Let me also do it. Keeping up with the Jonas's mentality. So let's switch this paradigm in our thinking. So from high thinking to, high living to no thinking, let's get back to simple living and high thinking. Then we can be content and fulfilled. So that is all in this shloka, shloka number 39. In the next video, we will talk about shloka number 40. Very beautiful shloka. Again, we'll dive deeper into this concept of lust. See you in the next video. Hare Krishna.